What's going on, you crazy bastards? You're back here with Rob Kimball from SonsOfWrestling.com for a WWE SmackDown review. Now, we start off the show with the Usos. Now, it looks like Jay's got his knee bandaged up and he's ready to go. So you got the Usos, Big Show, and Mark Henry versus the Dust Brothers and Luke Harper and Eric Rowan from the Wyatts. And you have Bray Wyatt looking on from the top of the ramp in his rocking chair. So now, during this match, Jimmy goes for a move and it looks like he tweaks his knee, the same knee that Jay Uso has fucked up. So now both Usos, knee problems, the Dust Brothers are going to take advantage of that. So hey, I think at Night of Champions we're going to have that title change to Gold and Stardust. But this was pretty damn cool. Big Show nails a fucking knockout punch Stardust, as Stardust did get some good work in here. So did Goldust earlier in the match here. And off this knockout punch, Jey Uso had tagged himself in right at the last minute. Uso splash picks up the victory. Pretty cool. And like I said, I see a night of champions, a title change going to Golden Stardust. It's just a prediction, and a prediction video will be up this coming week, sometime after Raw. Then we move on to Randy Orton and Seth Rollins and Kane. They're backstage, and looks like they're all on the same page finally. Just 2 months ago, they were in disarray, they didn't like each other at all. But now, they're all clicking, it's best for business. Then we have Bo Dallas versus Justin Gabriel. Justin Gabriel, where have you been? Excellent. They even mentioned he's a three-time tag team champion. And rightfully so, he didn't get a complete squash here. And Jack Swagger and Zeb come out. Bo Dallas goes into a routine saying he's America's sweetheart. And then he's going to do the national anthem. But Zeb cuts him off. And he says he should be working those late night selling snake oil, whatever those religious deals are. And this gets under Bo's skin, and Bo just goes and starts destroying Justin Gabriel. But like I said, he does get in some offense. Justin Gabriel gets in some good moves, and the guy's a great worker. I wish they used him more often, but we don't see much of Justin Gabriel, maybe once or twice a year. And like I said, great moves and shit. He does go for this awesome moonsault, misses it though, and this turns into the running Bulldog victory for Bo Dallas. And then he's still in a fucking fury and he calls in Jack Swagger, ready to rock, man. He's ready to go. So it's a nice side of Bo Dallas. And I like that, how vicious he gets real quick. And while Swagger comes in, they tangle up there for a minute by the ropes, but Jack Swagger looks to outpower him and Bo Dallas runs off, retreating up the ramp. So see what happens at Night of Champions. I think Bo Dallas is going to end up picking up the victory personally. Then we have Summer Rae versus Paige, and Layla's with Summer Rae. AJ Lee comes out on commentary, and this just quick match. Paige is just out to prove something against AJ. She locks in the Black Widow for the finish on Summer Rae. This pisses off AJ Lee, and Layla comes in after Paige. She's holding her belt high, ready to come in and do a little work to Paige, but AJ comes in and hits her with a Paige turn and skips off, just getting it right in her face, which is pretty cool. These guys are going back and forth and just trying to one-up each other. I like it. Then we have Mark Henry. He already competed earlier in the night, but now he has a competition in arm wrestling against Alexander Rusev. So pretty cool. Rusev comes, locks up. They didn't think that he would accept their challenge, as he quit or something in the Olympics back in the day. Gives a good speech, but then Rusev needs to put all this powder in his hands. First time slips out. Next time, well, Mark Henry crushes him pretty easily. Then Rusev wants to go left-handed, and they're going for it, and Mark Henry starts to take over that one. Looks like he's going for the win again, but Lana with a handful of that powder right into the face of Mark Henry. This turns into him getting kicked down into the mat, and then he goes to get up. He's still blinded and gets blasted by the big, nasty barefoot of Rusev. So Mark Henry laying on the ground. Russia looks strong going into the Night of Champions. I think it will be Rusev's first loss. Hopefully, if not, they're going to go with a huge, huge winning streak. And those can sometimes burden your character. So we'll see what happens there. Then we have Jericho backstage with Renee Young, and he plans to shred the Viper, Randy Orton. And he had a whole bunch of cool shit he had to say really, really fast, way better than I could do it. I just don't remember what he said. So check it out if you want. I'm sure it'll be one of those little interview deals on YouTube from WWE. It's worth a shot because Jericho with a mic, awesome. Then we have Mizdow and Miz versus Dolph Ziggler and R. Ziggler. R-Truth is in the gear of Ziggler. Awesome. Really, really cool. Decent match, too. These guys can all work. They're all really good. Miz being the least of them. But, hey, Miz does put in work, and he's playing his character. Awesome. And in the end, you get R. Ziggler nailing the zigzag, allowing Miz to catch, to get the pin on Mizdow, because the ref was looking away because Miz had just interfered the last pin attempt. So very cool ending, and I liked it, man. For little gimmick bullshit, this was fun, and the crowd, they actually had fun with it too. Awesome shit. And I would like to see more of R-Truth personally. I think he's great talent, and he's getting up there in age. He's not going to be around much longer. I mean, maybe 3-4 more years. That's about all you're going to get out of him, but he's really talented, man. Him and Justin Gabriel, too, man. They got to have these guys still in there doing a little more work. But after NXT last night, you got a lot of new guys coming up, too. So really good shit. Then we have Nikki backstage, and she's just talking about being a victim because of the Jerry Springer deal. And, you know, it looks to be that she's the victim, and Jerry Springer got hurt, and that's on Brie. And then we have AJ showing up, and then Paige shows up, and they want each other up and basically talk about Nikki's not an issue. It's just going to be Paige versus AJ in the end, and it'll be Paige winning again. But they take off, and Nikki says this may be a little easier than I thought. So she thinks she's going to probably will end up becoming champ at Night of Champions. I wouldn't doubt it. So on to the main event, Chris Jericho and Roman Reigns versus Randy Orton and Seth Rollins. Hell yes. All of it, really good shit. Then we have Jericho and Rollins in the ring, really good shit. Jericho locks in the walls of Jericho, and then, he gets out of that. Here we go for the fucking lion salt, and Randy Orton's there to meet him in the head with his fist. Boom! Clocks him down, and, this turns into pretty much the beatdown to Chris Jericho. And, really good shit. Vicious. Fucking Randy Orton. Just very vicious here. Going after him. Fucking beating the shit out of him. Seth Rollins comes in. Hits the Three Amigos. So where is this going? Is there a reason why he's doing that? I don't know. They say he's the architect or whatever. So we'll see what happens where Seth Rollins is going. I heard even in November, wherever the hell they're going, the John Cena will be feuding with Seth Rollins. So what's going to happen at Night of Champions? I don't know. But anyway, back to the match here. Finally, Jericho hits the hot tag to Roman Reigns, and he comes in destroying everyone. And, this turns into him going after Seth Rollins. Finally gets his hands on him, and this goes into the crowd, leaving just Jericho and Orton going at it. Orton's getting in the most work here. But as he goes for his little DDT, Jericho slips underneath, roll up, pin, victory, boom. Jericho pins Orton, awesome shit. So that was really cool, and it builds their match both separately going into Night of Champions, Orton and Jericho versus Reigns and Rollins. It's going to be awesome. Definitely tuning in to Night of Champions on the network for $9.99. That personally is a fucking awesome deal. I don't know how anyone can mock it. It's funny to talk about, but for $10, really, a pay-per-view, yes, absolutely. When they used to be $55, I don't know why people are even making a mockery of the whole thing. $10 is a fucking steal for all of us fans. Support pro wrestling. Follow me on Twitter at Rob Kimble Brand. Go to sonsofwrestling.com, click the t-shirts, get some new swag. Going into winter, I'm going to start making some new hoodies. So if you guys have any suggestions on what designs are already in there that you would like to be that have made as a hoodie. I will put that in my store for all of you. And like I said, all the money that I make from that, which is not much, goes into making this channel better, and soon will be live so I can interact while I'm actually recording with everybody. That will be so cool. I can't wait to do that. And the shows will be a hell of a lot longer than 12 to 15 minutes. They'll probably be about an hour, I would think, if we get enough people on board following along, supporting this channel, Sons of Wrestling. That's the way we do it. We love wrestling. So guys, it was fun, decent SmackDown, and can't wait for Night of Champions for only $9.99. Peace.